Today we have Ed Morgan, the music man. He plays music for kids and adults from 1 to 99. And he has been doing this for over 10 years or more, right?
Oh my God.
Or longer than that.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've been doing this as long as I can remember.
So anyway.
Not that far.
I am really looking forward to this, as I know you will too. So Ed, welcome.
All right. Well, thanks for coming out, you guys. And thank you, Adele, for asking me to come and sing for you guys today on Valentine's Day. So since it is Valentine's Day, when I was figuring out what songs I'd play, you know, I had a little criteria. First was, of course, it'd have to be some song about love in all its varied ups and downs. And secondly, and probably even more important, the songs that I like. And hopefully songs that you'll like. And I tried to pick songs that people would know, so I could hopefully get you guys to sing along with me. Especially Daryl. All right, so now having said that, I want to start out with a song that's not that well known. It's a song by Gordon Lightfoot, and it's pretty appropriate for a day like today. It's called Song for a Winter's Night. Song without thinking of Lennon and McCartney. I want play a couple of songs that Lennon and McCartney wrote, but they gave to other people to record. This is one that was recorded. It had a pretty big hit with by a band back then called Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas. It's called That to Me. If you ever leave me, I'll be sad and blue. Don't you ever leave me, I'm so in love with you. The birds in the sky would be sad and lonely if they knew that I was my one and only desire. If you're bad to me, the leaves on the trees would be soft. Put out to the public, there was a bit of a rivalry going on between the Beatles and a band called the Dave Clark Five. This is one of their songs.
Yeah.
couple by Lennon and McCartney that they actually recorded. I had to transpose this one. Because, you know, Paul McCartney still sings the songs. I don't know if you've seen him live or like videos of him playing live, but he still sings all these songs in their original key, which is pretty impressive. I can't do it. This one's called Here, There, and Everywhere. To lead a better life, I need my love to be
far away. We'll be together all along.
know, are familiar with Harry Nilsson. A lot of people, great. As you know, when the Beatles first came to the U.S., which was actually 60 years ago this month, their first show, their first appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show, they asked the press, well, who's your favorite American band? And John Lennon said, Nilsson. This is one of his songs. Oh, this is what, Harry Nilsson had a great career. He wrote a lot of songs that other people recorded. And his one hit, his one really big hit was the song called Everybody's Talking. You know, everybody's talking. And that's one song that he didn't write. But this one that he wrote that was a big hit for a band called Three Dog Night.
Thank you.
This one's really easy too. This is by, depending on the day you ask me, this is my second favorite songwriter in the world. His name's Warren Zevon. By the way, if you guys only know Werewolves of London, you really owe it to yourself to look into Warren Zevon's catalog, because he's got some amazing songs. But this one's called Let Nothing Come Between You. And all you gotta do is go like this.
And all your charms whenever I want you.
song from that British invasion period. This is a song by Jerry and the Pacemakers. They're probably all wearing pacemakers now. This is called Don't Let the Sun Catch You Crying.
Darling, something new, some things were
to. And this is probably the perfect song for Valentine's Day. And I had forgotten all about it until I was sitting with my dog at the vet's office and they had this TV on that played only music. And this song came up and I go, oh my God, that's perfect. It's called Cupid by Sam Cooke. Mm-hmm.
Thanks everybody for coming and celebrating Valentine's Day with us.